Hey down there, I know you're there, answer me.
I'm here.
What on earth for? What are you doing at the bottom of a well?
Thinking.
Why do you have to be at the bottom of a well to think?
This way I can really concentrate. It's nice and cold and quiet.
Do you do this a lot?
No, not a lot. I've only done it once before. Climbing into a well like this.
Well, is it working? Is it helping you think?
I don't know yet. I'm still experimenting.
Did you notice the ladder was gone?
Yeah, a while ago.
Did you know it was me who pulled it up?
No, that I did not know.
Well, who do you think did it?
I don't know. I don't know how to tell you this, but the thought never crossed my mind that somebody had taken the ladder. I thought it just disappeared, to tell you the truth.
What do you mean it just disappeared? Is that all by itself? It just disappeared?
Maybe so.
I know this is a sort of funny time to tell you this, but you're a pretty weird person. Now, there's not many people out there as weird as you are. Did you know that?
I'm not so weird to myself.
Then what makes you think that ladders can just disappear?
Well, you took it, didn't you?
Well, of course I did. That doesn't take much brain work to figure out.
But why?
Well, how many people go sit at the bottom of wells to think?
You've got them in there.
Do you have any food or drink down there?
A little water. I didn't bring any food with me.
How long have you been down there?
Since late yesterday.
You must be hungry.
I guess so.
You know, you might die down there. Depending on my mood, considering I'm the only one who knows you're there and I hid the rope ladder.
I'm sure you're right.
How do you feel about that?
Scared.
You don't sound that scared.
That's because it hasn't really sunk in yet.
Yeah, well, it has with me. I think it'd be a lot easier to kill someone than people think. I wouldn't have to do anything. I'd just have to leave you there. It'd be so easy. You know, just think how much you'd suffer lying there in the dark, dying little by little of hunger and thirst. Well, it wouldn't be easy.
I'm sure you're right.
You don't believe me, do you? You don't think I could do anything so cruel?
It's not that I believe you could or you couldn't. Anything can happen. The possibility is there, that's what I think.
Well, I'm not talking about possibility anyway. Okay, I've got an idea. You went through all that trouble just to climb down there so you could think, why don't I fix it so you can concentrate on your thoughts even better?
How would you do that?
How? Like this. Still alive? Answer, you're still alive.
I'm still alive.
You must be hungry.
I think so.
Still? Just I think so? It'll be a while before you starve to death then. People starve to death, a lot less easily if they have water.
I'm sure you're right.
No? I know I'm right. I did some research in the library this morning about hunger and thirst. Did you know someone once had dug around for 21 days?
No kidding.
He must have suffered a lot.
Yeah, really?
He survived, though. You know, he lost all his hair and his teeth. But, you know, even if he survived, it must have been terrible.
Really?
But I guess if you survive and you lose all your hair and your teeth, you can still lead a pretty normal life if you got a decent wig and false teeth.
Yeah.
You know. Well, I was just thinking, do you think people would, you know, if they kept on living the way we're doing it now, always healthy, never dying, do you think they'd take the time to think about things the way we're doing now? Think about it. You know, we think about basically everything, more or less. You know, religion, psychology, philosophy, logic, and literature. And I think that if death didn't exist, these complicated thoughts and ideas would never come into our world. So I guess that's just what I think. But people really need to take the time to think about what it means to be alive here and now, because we're all going to die sometime, right? But who would think about what it means to be alive if you're just going to go keep on living forever? Who would bother? They'd probably just think, oh, well, I've got got all the time in the world. I'll just think about it later. But we can't think about it later. We've got to think about it now. You know, I could be hit by a truck tomorrow afternoon, and you? Well, you could starve to death. And one morning, 3 days from now, you could be dead at the bottom of a well. You see, nobody knows what is going to happen, so we need death to make us evolve. And death is this huge and big, bright thing, and the bigger and brighter it gets, the more we drive ourselves crazy thinking about these things. Just tell me something.
What?
Down there, in the darkness, have you been thinking about your death? Have you been thinking about hell? You're going to die?
No. That's actually the one thing I haven't thought about.
Well, why not? You are literally facing death right now. I told you before, it's up to me whether you live or die.
You could drop a rock.
A rock? What are you talking about?
You could find a big rock and drop it on me.
Well, of course. Yeah, I could do that. But how have you not been thinking about your own death? Don't you think that's weird?
I guess so. I've been thinking about other things this whole time. I'm sure I'll start to think about death soon when I start to get hungry enough, but I've still got 3 more weeks to live, right?
Yeah, maybe. You know, that's what happened to that Russian guy, but that's only if you have water, and you don't have much water left, do you?
No, just a little bit.
Then you better be careful. Take little sips. Just take your time thinking about death and about how you're going to die. You've still got plenty of time. I just want you to think about your own death, okay? I'm just curious.
Curious?
Yes. Curious about death and what it feels like to die, Emily. Just curious.
Once upon a time, there was a small town on a page in a book which held letters, which in turn held thoughts. Thoughts of a death, thoughts of life, thoughts of a past already finished, and thoughts of a future not yet decided.
Went down, down, down to the well. And it was dark, and it was cold, and it was quiet. And she thought and thought and thought of a future full of light, so that even in the bottom of the well, in the dark, a future full of light appeared.